E-zoning for the main purpose of making the property eligible for some conditional use permits, which will be submitted to you in the upcoming month if the rezoning is approved. Property is located in the neighborhood activity center, and the comprehensive plans feature development map. As we talked about in the work session, this is that portion of Bemiss Road that is a little lower key intensity pattern between Castle Park and Northside Drive. Has a very strong residential development pattern in the past. Those converted to offices, also the development of multifamily, very much an RP kind of category. Personal services shop is one of the items the applicant is wanting to contemplate in the more intensive variety of that, which requires OP zoning and a conditional use, not allowed at all in RP zoning. Initially, I was opposed to the rezoning request, OP being a spot zoning within the RP, that is still a concern. However, RP and OP are almost interchangeable. The main difference is RP allows multifamily, OP does not. OP will allow a bank, RP does not. A lot of times, OP zoning is put in place to keep out multifamily development, such as when you're adjacent to a single-family neighborhood. So if this were the case, that it was all OP zoning, and the applicant was requesting a spot of RP, and we thought that the RP property being requested would accommodate, say, an apartment complex, that would be definitely an intrusion into the pattern. This is the opposite of that. There's already a mixture of offices, houses, and apartments. RP, this particular lot, is a corner lot. It is small, has an existing former residence, about 2,000 square feet, used as a professional office for the past many, many years. I think it's a accounting office originally. Has parking lots with about 9 spaces, plus some more room in the backyard. I don't see this becoming an apartment complex, or even if it did develop into a duplex or quadruplex, it would still fit in with the surrounding area. Site plan, you see the layout of the parking, subject property, the converted residence, and then this is the view from the side street from Randolph. The original carport, I guess, from the house is still there, but used as a parking space. And then the fenced-in backyard. The applicant has some other ideas in mind going forward, including an esthetician academy, which is part of our main use, the yoga studio, I think also perhaps a couple other things that will be sorted out when we get to the conditional use stage if the rezoning is approved. Adjacent to this, you have a pattern across Bemiss Road, some office buildings. This is straight across, still a single-family residence. It's an RP. And then, of course, just the subject property. So with that, it's just a zoning change. So staff has found the rezoning from RP to OP to be consistent with the comprehensive plan. It stands for exercise of zoning power, which are in your packet, and we're recommending approval.
Matt, did you state why the conditional use was set before us at this time? I'm just curious.
The city council, after a lot of confusion late last spring,
sure,
with some cases that were overlapping, has decreed that we will not process these simultaneous. And technically, they are correct. In order to be considered for the conditional use, the OP zoning has to be there. Some would argue that to process them simultaneously presumes that the zoning would be changed. So this keeps the decisions separate and not mixed together. So the rezoning has to take place, and I anticipate the next month the applicant would then turn in the conditional use application.
So I'm just curious, you're talking about platforms later, but that doesn't seem very developer friendly.
It doesn't seem like an effective use of anyone's time.
Whoever member governments have made it so to keep the decision separate. It's not written in turn development code that way for this. It is for character area amendments, but not for these other kinds of uses.
Makes no sense.
Okie doke. So, is there anyone here tonight who would like to speak on behalf of this request? If you'll come forward, please.
See you next.
Skipper, and I'm the applicant of 2317 Bemiss. I'm the owner of AS Aesthetics. I'm a licensed medical esthetician and a licensed medical tattoo artist. I've actually been doing business here in Valdosta for the past 3 years. I've been renting a small 6x9 space in the back of Wincy Salon downtown, and I've achieved such beautiful things in a small space so far. I have won Best Esthetician of Georgia, which was awarded to me by Georgia Business Journal, and it was voted on by our local community here. One thing that I believe sets my business apart from others in Valdosta is the fact that I have dedicated myself to a specialty niche, which is called the 3D Areola Restoration Tattoo, which is part of why I need a conditional use permit to do it in this building. This 3D Areola Restoration Tattoo was not offered here in Valdosta before I started offering it. I'm the only one to do it, and therefore I do work in conjunction with a lot of local doctors here in Valdosta, Dr. Moore, Dr. Merriman, and even Tallahassee Plastic Surgery has referred patients to me. It's a beautiful thing to offer the restoration tattoo for breast cancer survivors. It's one of their last steps of their journey, and I think it's really cool to be able to do the entire process of a breast cancer patient's journey from start to finish, from being diagnosed to the very end when they come to see me for their areola restoration tattoo. To be able to complete that whole process for a woman right here in Valdosta is really special, because they were driving out of town or even out of state for a realistic looking areola to complete them and make them feel confident again. So that is one dream and goal of mine that I want to keep pursuing. I'm looking to expand into that bigger space of 2317 because it is best suitable for my business at this point. As Mr. Martin mentioned, I do want to launch an advanced training academy for fellow professionals, licensed estheticians, cosmetologists, tattoo artists. I do believe that there is a big need for this in our industry and a big need for this in the city of Valdosta. Right now, there is nowhere for people of my profession to get advanced training other than going to Atlanta or, you know, up the East Coast into Florida and whatnot. So with my expertise of 7 years of being an esthetician and 3 years of entrepreneurship, I do believe I have what it takes to fulfill the dream of mine of being in 2317 Bemiss. So if you have any questions, I would love to answer them for you. Thank you so much for your time today, and thank you, Mr. Martin, for all your help.
So
I'll go to a point.
Oh, yeah, I'll go ahead.
So you're going to offer a variety of services out of this center.
Yes, sir. I already do over 20 aesthetic services, but the thing is I'm trying to combine aesthetics with tattooing because they're two separate licenses. So I think that's where it gets a little tricky too. You know, Rezone from RPOP allows me to do the aesthetic portion of my business, but I can't do any tattooing until I've been applied for the conditional use permit. But I don't do any, you know, traditional tattooing. This is not going to be a open till 3 a.m. neon signs outside. It is a, you know, very beautiful place that I would provide elegant, you know, inviting atmosphere for the survivors.
So we have employees or people renting rooms from you?
That's the goal, is to have two fellow estheticians come in, because I have the space to allow them to rent a space for me and start their dream and their journey, just like Lindsay Salon has helped me here in Valdosta. So, and then the lot of grass, if you want to eventually offer yoga classes or, you know, workshops, or just be part of the community and collaborate with different, you know, fellow businesses, and that's my goal, with, you know, utilizing the lot of grass in the back.
Great idea. So first off, let me say, grand dreams, amazing.
Oh,
I'm so proud of you.
Thank you.
We need more women entrepreneurs, young women entrepreneurs here. So hats off to you.
Thank you. Grand dreams. I love that.
And then the areola restoration, is that tattooing?
Yes, ma'am.
So that is not, you will not be able to do that until you get your conditional use.
Right, yes,
okay.
Ma'am.
That's a
You, she can tattoo something right now, but she can't do that?
No. Tattoo parlor requires
We got neon signing. We not putting a dragon on nobody.
That's why it's a conditional use.
So are you from this area?
I'm from Madison, Florida.
I just agree with what Madam Chair said. That is amazing.
Oh,
and I do apologize that you got to come back.
Oh, it's okay. It'll be worth it, I know.
Are you in the building already?
I work on the building, yes, sir.
Man.
And I've been diligently working, even though it may not work out, but I've been diligently working at it.
She offers a pretty wide range of services, not just that. Some of what she offers is allowed in RP zoning, but she's
My sister-in-law was the first esthetician in Valdosta. She still practices, Rhonda Tomlinson.
Oh, yes.
And so I've had a fondness for estheticians for a very long time. But what you're doing with the restoration for breast cancer survivors, I just think it's tremendous. And the fact that those ladies can do that here in Valdosta and not have to go somewhere else, I just think is amazing. So hats off to you.
Thank you so much.
Fantastic.
Can we just go make a motion now?
Can we just, yeah.
Can we just go make a motion to do that tonight?
So, congratulations.
Thank you. The commissioner don't care if we do it or not, so. Maybe two of them don't care.
Well, since it's in the city limits, that probably wouldn't matter much.
Well, let's look at the bright side. We get to see this little lady again.
You get to see that smile.
Well, and then you also get to hear more about the other kinds of things.
Right.
So, just curious, so you've done that locally already?
I should have brought a picture to show y'all.
Okay, when you come back for the CU, bring us some examples.
Okay, I will.
Love to see your work.
Absolutely.
That's amazing. Appreciate it.
Thank you guys so
Thank
much.
Thank you so
I appreciate
much.
Y'all.
Wow.
Okay. Well, that being said, I'm not even going to allow anybody to let
me speak.
She's just going to
No, I meant to speak again.
Oh, yeah, no, we
do. No. But yes, Christy, please come up.
Sorry, I'll be back.
No, I was joking.
I totally get it. I have to say, I completely agree with you that this is not a business-friendly policy making people come twice because...
No, it's not.
I'm Christy Moore. I've lived 2009 North Sherwood Drive, Valdosta, here in the city. But I can speak today as a character witness, which I understand often that does not matter in the zoning process. But I would also understand if I was sitting in your shoes as I'm heard to come inside, which I know she'll come back for. But I did just want to speak to I have known Ashley and been one of her clients for a year now, since I moved to Valdosta. I promise you she is not trying to pull it up from y'all. She's one of the most professional people I've ever dealt with, and the work she does is phenomenal. And I hope she does bring pictures to share with y'all because it is truly amazing. And she's been talking about this. She's not going to say this to y'all, but she has looked at many, many buildings, and it's been very difficult to find a space to have her business. And so she was so excited when she got this. And we know, you know, we've talked through in the future looking at the zoning before you get there. But, you know, a lot of business owners know their business, and they're experts, just like Ashley, but they're not experts at this. And we all know those people, right? I mean, we've probably been those people before. I know many of y'all own businesses. So I appreciate y'all giving her the support, but I do think, as we've been showing, that we really need to support more entrepreneurs like this. So I appreciate y'all giving her considerable.
And don't you leave. And so what Ms. Christie has not mentioned is that she is the executive director for the Chamber of Commerce.
Oh, she mentioned that, yeah.
Now, yeah, you should mention that. And to see you up here and supporting one of our businesses is just phenomenal. And back to your point, being a very business-friendly atmosphere, and just not being a very business, I completely concur, and I hope that we can make changes in that regard in the future.
And we do talk about that being more business-friendly,
right,
in the whole city-county thing. Just don't let me go on deaf ears. We do talk about it all the time. So, I mean, in your position, I'd be marched up there.
Absolutely.
I now have something to do tomorrow, for sure.
Yeah. Thank you, Christy.
Follow.
I appreciate it.
Thanks for coming forward.
Appreciate it.
And Christy is also one of my fellow Leadership Lounge students this year.
Can you
say
that?
I sure can. And I'm proud of her. All right. I do have to say legally, is there anyone here tonight who wishes to speak against this request? If you come up here, we'll torture you, but if there is anyone... Joking aside, all right, no one's speaking again, so I'll turn it back over to the commissioners for any further discussion.
I'm going to ask a question. Do we have any concerns based on parking spots?
No, it's based on office capacity, number of employees, or the size of the building. If she is proposing another building, of course, changes the site plan, it might trigger some additional parking, and that's all future discussion. And just something to point out, if this property were zoned commercial, we wouldn't be having a conversation.
Right.
If the property were already zoned OP, she would just be coming through once for its conditional use. So it's because of the property, not because of the process.
Right.
And Unfortunately, she got into the property before realizing it was not zoned commercial.
And what was the size of this building?
It's about 2,300 square feet, I think.
Okay.
No, 2,023.
You'll be growing through that faster than you can. All right. I'll ask for a motion, please.
Madam Chair.
Commissioner Bailey.
On the case set before since evening, VA-2022-01, I love when I get to say that it does me nothing but great pleasure to say that I make a motion to approve the rezoning of 0.45 acres from RP to OP.
I'll second.
To recommend approval.
Yeah, I'm gotcha. Sorry, what did I say?
Approve.
Well, I think we should approve it right now. You can misspell duplexes, but I can't say that.
Right. All right. And just so Ms. Trini knows, that was seconded by Commissioner Miller. All right. Any discussion on the motion? If not, everybody raise your right hand. All those in favor? All those against? And the motion carries. Congratulations, Ms. Ashley, and we look forward to seeing you next month.
Thank you so much.